Pull out a pencil and paper today, take some notes. You can always get good advice on love, can't you? You always get good advice on marriage, good advice on relationships. Like the guy who went to work and said, my wife is just bugging me. And his friend said, well, I'll tell you what you do. You go home and you lay the law down. You tell your wife how it is. So he went home and he did that. He didn't see him for a long time. When he saw him, he said, well, how'd it go? He said, well, he said, I went home and did what you told me to do. I told her how it was and how the cow ate the cabbage, and said, I didn't see her for 2 days. But the third day, I could see a little bit out of one eye. How many know he got the wrong advice? And this is also what we think. Well, if I was married to that person, if I had a relationship with that person, to be better. You know, if you were married to me, I would probably be your worst nightmare. Now, if you were married to Carrie, you'd be blessed. You know what I mean? Let's go that way. But we fantasize, well, what would it be like with this person? Or what if that person was my friend? Or what if, you know, I had that relationship or that connection or that insight? Well, I just think we all have trouble with relationships, don't you? I mean, one of the most difficult things is relationships. But the only thing you can take to heaven is you and relationships. You can't take your car. You can't take your money. There's no U-Hauls behind hearse, no pockets and shrouds. So the only thing you can take is other people, your relationships. Look with me at John 13. Listen to what Jesus told those disciples. He says, verse 34, I give you a new commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you, that you also love one another just like I love you. Now listen, that is a big deal, right? As I've loved you, now you love one another as I've loved you. By this, say that with me, by this will all men know that you're my disciples if you have love one toward another. Folks, this whole kingdom principle is built on love. Dal said it a moment ago, for God so loved the world that he gave. How did you get into this kingdom? Because God loved you. How did he love you? He loved you sacrificially. He loved you before you loved him. That's what Paul says. While we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Why did he die for us? Because he loved us. He wanted us to respond to him out of that great love. God is the greatest lover. The greatest force in the universe is the love of God. Matter of fact, God is love. He's powerful, he's holy, but let me tell you what he is. God is perfect love. And we have to understand that. Love is the basis of all good relationships. Now, there's a lot of emphasis today on different things of the church. You know, we're looking at being, you know, contemporary. We want lighting and we want great music and, you know, we want to get themed and we want this and we want that. Let me tell you, this whole thing's not built on that. It's not built on that. It's built on relationships. Number one, our relationship with God. And when we have that relationship with God, then we can react and in turn love each other. Because some of us are more difficult to love. I deserve a better amen than that. You see, when we love, we will show that love through works. Now, you say, I don't think I've ever read that in the Bible. Well, faith without works is dead. Could we just extend that out? Love without works is probably dead too. So if we really love people, we will show works or affection or symbols or tokens of our love out of that relationship. So if faith without works is dead, then love without works is probably also dead. So we have to have tokens and expressions of that love. With the marriage relationship, guys, how many of you know it's probably good to remember your anniversary? Her birthday, Christmas, those are tokens of your love, your expression. How many of you know it's not good when you don't remember her birthday or the anniversary or Christmas? I mean, don't buy her a screwdriver set for Christmas. Or turtle wax for the anniversary. How many of you know your token of love needs to be a little bit more than that? Listen, I'm preaching better than what you think, guys. I'm giving you some good advice. You see, that is an expression of our love. Let me tell you how it kind of translates biblically. You remember when Peter failed, the Lord denied him? And the Lord said, Peter, before this night is over, you're going to deny me. And of course, Peter couldn't, he couldn't grasp that. Hey, these guys may do it. I'd never do that. You know, I'm Pete. You know, Peter had a way of opening his mouth, sticking his foot in all the time. You talk about men of like passions. How many of you know Peter's a lot like us? Big boast, low return. So he said, oh, I'd never do that. Before the rooster crowed in the morning, do you know that Peter denied the Lord three times that night? Don't know him, don't know him. Curse, don't know him. Remember when Jesus met him, Sea of Galilee, and this is what he asked him. He said, Peter, do you what? Love me. Peter, do you love me? Third time, Peter, do you love me? You say you love me, but what are the tokens of your love? But listen to what Jesus said. If you love me, feed my lambs. If you love me, there should be a response. If you love me, feed my sheep. If you love me, feed my sheep. What is he saying? Love should have expression. Whether it's a friendship love, husband and wife love, brotherly love, sisterly love, it should have expressions. Folks, these pews have never sent a card to anybody that was sick. This altar never made a phone call to anybody who's been discouraged. This sound system never took food to any family that had a death. Are you with me? This carpet has never went to the aid of someone who's been at their wit's end. You say, well, who does that? We do that. It's tokens of our love. You know, someone in the youth group is going through a rough time. Maybe you didn't make the team, or you failed a test, or you broke up with your girlfriend or your boyfriend. I mean, who's there to pick them up? Nothing over the youth building does that. Listen, that stage doesn't do that. That altar doesn't do that. That pulpit doesn't do that. We do that. And when people come into the kingdom of God and they want to feel love, guess who's the expressors of that love? That's us. Angels don't come down and do it. The seraphim doesn't come down and do it. I tell you who does it. We do that. Love me like you mean it. Say that with me. Love me like you mean it. 1 John 4:8, for he who does not love does not know God. Well, that's powerful, isn't it? For God is love.